JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for June the 18th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued to outperform all but one of the other major currencies. It gained the most against NZD, AUD, and CHF in that order, while it lost some ground only versus the Japanese yen. Now, the strengthening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen combined with the weakness in the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi suggests that financial markets continue to trade in a risk-off environment yesterday and today in Asia. However, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that the major EU and US indices traded mixed, with Nasdaq rising 0.87% and hitting a fresh record high. Sentiment improved somewhat during the Asian session today. Although Japan's Nikkei slid somewhat, China's Shanghai Composite, Hong Kong's Hang Seng, and South Korea's KOSPI traded in the green. Now, it seems that the hawkish turn by the Fed had a bigger impact in the FX market rather than in equities. Logically, in an environment where the pace for interest rate increases was brought forth, someone would have expected Nasdaq to underperform notably, as the value of high growth tech stocks is highly affected by changes in interest rates. Higher interest rates mean lower present values for such firms. Nonetheless, it seems that investors rushed into adding such stocks to their portfolios, perhaps to take advantage of the limited time left for low interest rates. In any case, with the Fed also initiating a discussion over a potential quantitative easing tapering and noting that the conversations will continue in the months to come, and be guided by the pace of the economic recovery, we prefer to keep paying extra attention to the economic data and what Fed officials have to say on the matter. Strong economic data could raise speculation that the Fed may soon decide to start scaling back its bond purchases at a faster pace than previously thought, which combined with remarks by Fed officials that this may be the case, could result in another round of selling in equities. However, taking into account how equities reacted in the aftermath of Wednesday's decision, we would expect something like that to impact more the currency world. In other words, we would expect the US dollar and other safe havens to strengthen, and the risk-sensitive Aussie, Kiwi, and Loonie to weaken. Our preference for taking advantage to such an environment are AUD-USD, NZD-USD, AUD-JPY, and NZD-JPY. Despite the latest rally in the Swiss franc, we prefer to leave it out of the equation for now, as yesterday the S&P kept its policy unchanged and maintained its dovish stance, repeating that the franc remains highly valued and that they are ready to intervene in the FX market when deemed necessary. Besides the S&P, we also had a bag of Japan decision during the Asian session today. The meeting resulted in no fireworks, with officials maintaining their policy unchanged and extending the deadline for pandemic-related programs by 6 months, as was mainly expected to happen either at this meeting, either at the next one. The bank also unveiled a plan to boost funding for fighting climate change, for which it will release a preliminary outline at its next gathering. Again, did not react to the decision, staying mainly driven by the Fed's hawkish stance. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK retail sales for May. Although headline sales missed their forecast, the core rate came in well above its own consensus. For the rest of the day, the calendar appears relatively light, with no major releases on the agenda. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.